Hi guys, thank you for joining me. I hope you are enjoying your evening. Early this morning, there was a magnitude 3.1 earthquake 50-60 miles west of Las Vegas, Nevada. What makes this earthquake so significant? It was probably caused by the Pahrump Fault Zone. The Pahrump Fault Zone is an active fault zone and represents a potential seismic hazard for Las Vegas. And the longer the fault, the more dangerous it is. And this fault is over 100 kilometers in length. So that would be 60 miles in length. And this fault is capable of producing a magnitude 7 or greater earthquake. So using Google Earth, let's bring this out. Let me close this out for you. And we'll go to location of Las Vegas, Nevada. Over there. Yeah, it's only 50 miles away. ResearchGate has an image of the fault zone with Las Vegas. It's almost, this area here is almost a completely straight fault. It's a right lateral strike slip fault. It is in an area called the Stewart Valley. Now, for a hazard assessment from 2000, and that was 21 years ago, they figured if there was a magnitude 7.0 earthquake on the Pahrump Valley Fault Zone, there would be $200 million to $800 million in economic loss. $200 million for Nye County alone. Major damage to approximately 6,000 buildings. 20 to 140 people would be needing public assistance or shelter. And 20 fatalities. Figures could be higher because the population in Nye and Clark counties has increased by about 30%. As of 2000, the probability of an earthquake of a magnitude 6 or greater occurring within 50 kilometers, that would include the Las Vegas area, is a 5 to 10% chance for the Pahrump magnitude 6. Then for the French Mountain Fault, which is up over here on the east side of Las Vegas, they estimate that a 6.6 earthquake on the French Mountain Fault would have $4.4 to $17.7 billion in economic losses. Major damage to approximately 30,000 buildings. 10,000 to 40,000 people would be homeless. 3,000 to 11,000 people needing public shelter, probably because they wouldn't have any friends or family to move in with. 3,000 to 11,000 people would need medical aid, means they got injured. 700 to 3,000 people needing hospitalization. 100 to 400 people would have life-threatening injuries, and there would be between 200 to 800 fatalities. And they have an image here talking about how to be prepared for an earthquake. It says non-structural damage can be easily prevented, such as bolting the shelves to the walls. It's a quick, cheap fix. There he is fixing it. Shows you how old this report is. This is a computer screen being secured, probably sticky tape. Refrigerators being bolted to the floor. But as I've said, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. And this earthquake and any other earthquake should be a wake-up call to have heavy objects removed from above where you sit, where you sleep. Know how to turn off your water and gas. Have medical supplies, extra food and water, not just for yourself, but for your pets. And have a backup of a backup plan. What if the neighbor that's supposed to help you and come and see if you're all right or come to your assistance, what if they are too busy or injured to come to your assistance? So what are your thoughts? Please put those comments down below. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you very much for your support. Please, please stay safe. Please be prepared. And I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.